Dear students, welcome to the second lecture of Cell Biology and Biotechnology. Let us begin with a small recap of what we have learned in our last lecture. First, we have learned about cell biology, the study of cells, types, functions, etc. Then, we have learned about stem cells. Stem cells are undifferentiated mass of cells that can be developed into any type of cell. Then, we have learned about types of stem cells, that is embryonic and adult stem cells. The stem cells that are there in the embryo stage are called embryonic stem cells, and the stem cells found in adults are called adult stem cells. Then we have learned about pluripotency, that is the ability of the stem cell to get differentiated or transformed into any type of cell is called pluripotency. Then we have learned about the uses of stem cells in two types, that is cell therapy or regenerative therapy and organ transplantation. Now, let us see our homework questions. The first question is how to preserve stem cell. The stem cell first will be extracted from the source. The extracted stem cells will be preserved or collected in a small sterile vials. These vials are like miniature test tubes. These will be preserved in liquid nitrogen from minus 135 to minus 190 degrees Celsius. These can be preserved for a longer time, that is more than 20-30 years, and can be used when needed. Here a question may arise. So the stem cell can be used only to the person from whom the stem cell is collected? No. There are some techniques through which we can find match for whom the stem cell is needed and can be used for those people as well. The next question is, what is grafting? Grafting is vegetatively joining one plant with the other. In this, the stem and root part, which is called rootstock, is joined with the tender shoot of the other plant, which is called the scion. The reason for doing grafting is to improve productivity of the plant, to make it disease resistant, to grow dwarf trees, that is the trees that are shorter in height, and many other purposes. The figure in the slide clearly explains how grafting is done. Let us move on to today's topic, organ transplantation. Why one should undergo organ transplantation? Various parts in the body may be completely functionless or become less effective due to reasons like aging, accident, infection, disorders, etc. Life of such person become miserable and sometimes fatal also. Organ transplantation will be their best option. Availability of donor is an important aspect in organ transplantation. Every person has a pair of kidney. A person can lead a healthy life with a single kidney. So, a person can donate one of their kidneys. Also, skin from certain parts of the body can be donated. Before donation, factors like age, blood group, and many other things of the recipient and donor need to be paid attention. Apart from that, organs like heart and eyes can be donated after death only. This slide shows you the organs that can be transplanted. Organs like heart, pancreas, kidney, skin, lungs, liver, and bones can be transplanted. Organ donation and transplantation comes under the control of Transplantation Human Organs Act 1994 and subsequent amendments of 2009, 2011, and 2014, so that the overall process will be transparent and no person is cheated. The next topic is organ and body donation. It is traditional to dispose the human body after death. Due to advancement in science, people realize that human organs can function even after death for some time under certain conditions. The concept of organ donation and body donation have emerged after realizing that the organs can save the life of other persons. A liberal view behind this concept is that our organs should be used for some other needful persons and make their miserable life comfortable. The awareness of organ and body donation is increasing in the country. Life of many people can be saved. Blind people can see or get the vision again, and the donated body and organs can also be used for medical research purposes. NGOs and government plays an important role in creating awareness about this organ and body donation. So far, we have learned about organ and body donation and organ transplantation. Now, let us move on to our next topic, biotechnology. This word biotechnology is not new for you, as you have learned something on it in your previous classes. Now, let us recollect what is meant by biotechnology. Bringing about artificial genetic changes and hybridization in organisms for human welfare is called biotechnology. The concept of tissue culture, animal husbandry, rearing of silkworm, etc. comes under this field. Now, what are the fields that are involved in biotechnology? Biotechnology has been useful in many fields like medicine, agriculture, industry, and environmental fields. What is the impact of biotechnology in agriculture and related fields? In agriculture, biotechnology has been useful in producing or in making crops that are disease and drought resistant, increase in productivity, and many other qualities of crops. Not only for crops, it is used to increase the shelf life of fruits and vegetables also. Various branches of science like cytology, biochemistry, molecular biology, genetic engineering, etc. are included in the field of biotechnology. There is considerable progress mainly in the field of pharmacy and agriculture due to biotechnology. Let us discuss the main areas included in biotechnology or where they are applied. Uses of various abilities of microbes like yogurt from milk and alcohol from molasses are included in biotechnology. Uses of productivity of cells like antibodies and vaccines are also included in this field. Uses of biomolecules like genes and proteins for human welfare and also increasing plant and animal productivity is also included in biotechnology. Use of genetic and non-genetic techniques like plant tissue culture are also part of biotechnology. What are the benefits of biotechnology? It has become possible to increase the per hectare yield irrespective of the limitation of crop and land area. Expenses on disease control have been minimized since the development of resistant varieties, that is, the crops that are resistant to various types of diseases. And due to development of fast fruit-setting varieties, per annum yield has been increased. Development of stress-resistant varieties which can withstand variable temperature, water, and change in fertility of soil and climate has also become possible due to advancement in biotechnology. Let us recollect what we have learned in today's lecture. First, we have learned about organ transplantation. People whose organs are completely functionless or less in function undergo organ transplantation. Then, organ and body donation have become increasingly possible due to advancement in science and also awareness of people. Then, we have learned about biotechnology. It is about bringing artificial genetic changes and hybridization in organisms for the welfare of human beings. Then, we have learned about the benefit of biotechnology in various fields like medicine, industry, agriculture, and environmental fields. We will see in elaborate the application of biotechnology in the coming sessions. The homework for the day is learn about development of biotechnology in India. Thank you.